Hi there guys, my name is Nataloon, and welcome back to Undertale. Apparently it did not end there. My niece told me, no, go back, reload it! So that's what we're doing. I'm gonna turn it down, because for some reason it's always super crazy loud. Am I just wandering through darkness? Oh, fuck you, Flowey. Howdy! It's me, Flowey! Flowey the Flowey! I owe you a huge thanks. You really did a number on that old fool. Without you, I never could have gotten past him. But now, with your help, he's dead. And I've got the human souls. Flowey, I'm gonna kill you. Boy, I've been empty for so long. Feels great to have a soul inside me again. I can feel them wiggling. Oh, you're feeling left out, aren't you? Well, that's just perfect. After all, I only have 6 souls. I still need one more. Before I become God. And then, with my newfound powers, monsters, humans, everyone. I'll show them all the real meaning of this world. Oh, I forget about escaping to your old save file. It's gone forever. You dick! But don't worry, your old friend Flowey has worked out a replacement for you. I'll save over your own death. So you can watch me tear you to bloody pieces. Over and over and over. What? Do you really think you can stop me? You really are an idiot. I might die, but I'm gonna try to kill the hell out of you, Flowey. You dickbag. Can't move. And that looks like a giant spider critter. Woo! Holy crap! That's new, and that's different. Holy balls! Am I supposed to? Ah! Oh! Supposed to do? It's all just a bad dream. And you're never waking up. No, bitch. It's not how this is gonna work. That's not how this is gonna work. Nope, bitch. You? Are gonna die. Think I'd be satisfied killing you only one time? Okay, bitch. Man, that's creepy looking. That is, like, super creepy looking. Look at his eyes. Just, yeah. Super scary. Super spooky. Woo! Where am I? Yep. 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 Fight! How do I not die? eyeballs. I'll be right back. Okay. Holy shit. Flowey's insane. Well, we knew that at the beginning, but extra crazy. Look at this. I gotta turn it down so that I don't murder everyone's ears. Ah! No! Fight! Warning. Warning what? Oh no. Oh no. I can't do this. Act! I call for help! Help, please! Oh, it is! Help! Yes, thank you! Oh gosh! Yes, oh my god! No! Jesus! Nukes! Why nukes? Why nukes? Why for the nukes? Whoa! This is entirely different! Jesus! Holy crap! What now? React! Yes! Call for help! Call for bloody help, please! Help! Please move faster, you useless twat! Jesus! What will happen if you defeat me? I don't know, but I want to find out! Such thing as happy endings. Bugger you! This is all that's left! Stop laughing, you smug, cheeky bastard! Ah! Woo! Shit! He's firing his lasers! Balls! Fight! Oh! Ooh, flies! Stop shooting flies at me! God, you douche pickle! Warning! Purple heart! shoot me? What's this one? Cruelty. Slaughter. Ruin. Death. Act. Act, 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 act. I call for help. Please help! Help! Happiness. Luck. Relief. Kindness. I didn't get enough help. I needed more. I needed so much more. Guys, I'm terrible at this. Green. It's my favorite color. Let's go. Holy balls! Jesus. Oh, act, 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 act. Call for help, please. Someone, come help me. Yes, I need those donuts of health and healing and deliciousness. I don't know what they were, but they look like donuts. Ah! Christ! Freaky little bastard! Fight for your life, little boy! I can't see where I even am. Stop shooting fingers at me! Freaking weird! Oh man, what is this? Oh, he's actually shooting at me! Let's go back again. Yes, I know I suck. Shut up. Are you really that desperate? Yes, maybe. Shut up. Suck it, Flowey. Suck a big one. Bloody flies. Okay. Let's go back. Let's try not to die. Faster. be happening! You! What? You idiot! Oh god. Did you really think you could defeat me? I'm the god of this world, and you? You're hopeless. Hopeless and alone. Golly, that's sad, I think it said. Your worthless friends can't save you now. Call for help, I dare you. Cry into the darkness. Mommy, Daddy, somebody help! See what good it does you. I called for help. You don't look so happy, Flowey. But nobody came. Boy, what a shame. Nobody else is gonna get to see you die. Crap. I can't. What happened? What? How'd you... Well, I'll just... What? Where are my powers? Yeah, human souls! Boom! What are they doing? No! You can't do that! You're supposed to obey me! Stop! Stop it! Shriveled up little douche bagel. I picked Mercy. What are you doing? You really think I've learned anything from this? No. Sparing me won't change anything. Killing me is the only way to end this. If you let me live... I'll come back. Excuse me. Kill you. I'll kill everyone. I'll be ready for you. I'll kill everyone you love. He's confused. Why? Why are you being so nice to me? Maybe nobody was nice to him. I can't understand. Maybe nobody's ever been nice to him. That's why he's such a douche. I can't understand! I just can't understand. Flowey ran away. That the king is dead. I mean, I got to go home, which is great, but they're still doomed. Is there anything after the credits? Huh? I can't... What? Ring, ring. Oh. Heya. Is anyone there? Well, I'll just leave a message. So, it's been a while. The queen returned and is now ruling over the underground. She's instated a new policy. All the humans who fall here will be treated not as enemies, but as friends. It's probably for the best anyway. Human souls the king gathered seem to have disappeared, so, that plan ain't happening anytime soon. But even though people are heartbroken over the king, and the thing Things are looking grim for our freedom. The Queen's trying her best not to let us give up hope. So, hey, if we're not giving up down here, don't give up wherever you are, okay? Who knows how long it will take. But we will get out of here. Sons! Who are you talking to? Oh, nobody. What? Nobody? Can I talk to them too? Here, knock yourself out. Wait a second! I recognize this number! Attention, human! I, the Great Papyrus, am now Captain of the Royal Guard! It's everything I've ever dreamed of! Except, instead of fighting, we just water flowers. So that's ever so slightly different. And we're helping Dr. Alphys with her research. She's gonna find a way to get us out of here. Undyne is helping her too. Though, to be honest, her method of helping seems kind of explosion-inducing. But I think Alphys likes having her around. Uh-oh. Hey, what are you up to, punk? Please, don't noogie the phone! Hey, who's in charge here? Me! Oh, yeah, that's right. I quit my job as leader of the Royal Guard. Actually, since we won't be fighting anymore, the Royal Guard totally disbanded. There's, only one member now. But he's extremely good. Yeah, he is. Come here. Please don't noogie the skeleton! Anyways, now I'm working as Alpha's lab assistant. We're gonna find a way out of this dump once and for all. Oh, yeah, and I'm a gym teacher at the Queen's new school. Did you know I can bench press 7 children? Awesome, right? Hey, I'm sorry about what happened with Asgore. You were just doing what you had to. It's not your fault, hey. Darn it. I missed the big guy. Come on, Undyne. Snap out of it. I guess I'll tell you how Alphys is doing. Well, she's the same as ever. Maybe a little more reclusive than normal. Seems like something's really bothering her. But she can get through it. I'm there supporting her. That's what friends are for, right? Hey, wherever you are, I hope it's better than here. It took a lot of sacrifice for you to get there. So, wherever you are, you have to try to be happy, okay? For our sakes. We'll feel better knowing our trouble was worth it. We're all with you. Everyone is. Even the Queen. Hey! Wait a second! Toriel! Toriel! Do you wanna... She says she's busy. But if she knew who we were talking to, we wouldn't get the phone back for at least a few hours. We have the mercy to spare you from her. But call back anytime, okay? She'd love to talk. Oh, oops. This thing's almost out of batteries, so I hate to cut this short, but be seeing you, okay, buddy? Bye-bye for now! See ya, punk. Click. That was the sweetest voicemail ever. Flowey? Why? why? Why did you let me go? Don't you realize that being nice just makes you get hurt? Look at yourself. You made all these great friends, but now you'll probably never see them again. Not to mention how much they've been set back by you. Hurts, doesn't it? If you had just gone through without caring about anyone, you wouldn't have to feel bad now. So, I don't get it. If you really did everything the right way, why did things still end up like this? Why? Is life really that unfair? Say, what if I told you I knew some way to get you a better ending? You'll have to load your save file and... Well, in the meantime, why don't you go see Dr. Alphys? It seems like you could have been better friends. Who knows? Maybe Only she's got the key to your happiness. See you soon. I don't trust Flowey as far as I can throw him.
I'm good.
One day, war broke out between the two races. After a long battle, yeah, we know that part. Let's see if it continues us anywhere. Yep, it just has us at this old battle. Alright guys, I believe that is actually the end. And we defeated Flowey, we made it home, and our friends, all except for Asgore here, are safe. Where it ends. Because I don't think that Dr. Alphys... Well, maybe. Maybe, you know, because last time I went back to the lab, the door was locked and shut, and I couldn't say hi. I think she's upset that I beat up Metaton. But really, I mean, I had no choice. I had no choice but to beat up Metaton. So let's see. Let's see if Dr. Alphys will forgive us. Maybe. Let's get through here. Man. I'm still reeling about the fact that Flowey killed the king. God, Flowey's such a douchebagle. Oh, I can just go through here. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's find... Ring! Hey! This is Undyne. Shut up, Papyrus! This was your idea. Human, you have to deliver something for me. Please? I'm at Snowden in front of Papyrus's. See ya, punk! Okay. Let's go meet up with Undyne. Let's go see what's up. Looks like that extra little tidbit. Oh, no, I can't go that way. I need to go this way. Past the theater stage and past this fella here. Past, what was her name? Moffat? No, I'm thinking, yeah, Doctor Who. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I wonder what's going on. Because it's like an extra little tidbit. Yep, there's that guy. He got, intimidated into spending all his money on a donut. Guy's got no backbone! Left floor, one. So let's go, meet up in Snowden. And... try to figure this out. Maybe it's something for, Alphys. Give her a ride? Yes, I want to ride on the boat. Where will we go today? Snowden! And we're off! I mean, if the human world is anything like this human world, I wouldn't... Besides, you know, my family and friends, I wouldn't want to go back. Beware of the man who came from the other world. Weird. Alright, thanks for the ride, dude. Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. I think it's past the library over here. Yep, there you guys are. Hey! Hey, I have something to give you, but you're carrying way too much. Am I? Oh, yeah! So, I have a favor to ask you. I need you to deliver this letter to Dr. Alphys. Huh? Why don't I do it myself? Well, it's kind of personal, but we're friends, so I'll tell you. Highland sucks! I don't want to have to go over there. So here you go. You got Undyne's letter. Oh, and if you read it, I'll kill you. Thanks so much! You're the best. Can I say hi? Undyne writes a lot of letters, but she can never seem to find the right words. So when she goes to deliver them herself, she always quits so she can go back and rewrite. That's why she asked you. Because you have no standards. Thanks, bro. Dude, I got no standards. Tra-la-la, care for a ride? Yes, I would like to ride in the boat. I want to go to Hotland. Then we're off. Freaky cat boat. Freaky cat boat. Ah. Okay. Ah. So let's go find Dr. Alphys. And I'll have an eyelash in my eyeball. Ah! Ah! I think it's this way? It's this way. The door has no mail slot. Slide the letter under. No, I want to knock. Why can't I knock? Okay, I slide the letter under. Slide the letter under the door and give it a knock. Oh, no. Is that another letter? I don't want to open it. Can't I just slide it back out? No. I can't keep doing this. I'll read this one. It's shut kind of strongly, isn't it? Wait a second. Hey, if this is a joke, it's... Oh my god? Did you write this letter? It wasn't signed, so I had no idea who could have... Oh my god, no. That's adorable. And I had no idea you wrote that way. That's surprising, too. After all the gross stuff I did, I don't really deserve to be forgiven. Much less, this? And so passionately, too. You know what? Okay, I'll do it. It's the least I can do to make it up to you. Yeah, let's go on a date! A date? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Sorry! I'm still getting dressed! How do I look? My friend helped me pick out this dress. She's got a great sense of, anyway, let's do this thing. Hey, wait. Actually, we still can't start the date yet. I've got to give you items to raise your affection statistic first. That'll increase the chance of successful outcome to the date. Can't talk. Right? Anyway, don't worry, I'm prepared. But Undyne has the crush on you. I've been stockpiling gifts in anticipation for a date like this. First, I've got some metal armor polish. Maybe you can't use that. But I also brought some waterproof cream for your scales. Your scales. How about this magical spear repair kit that I... Hey, let's forget about the items. Let's just start the date. Yeah, let's, date. Dating's awkward. Like this. Do you... like... anime? Yeah, hey, me too! Hey, let's go somewhere. But where's a good place to go on a date? I've got it! Let's go to the garbage dump! Here we are! This is where Undyne and I come all the time. We find all sorts of great stuff here. She's really... You have a crush on Undyne. Oh no. That's her over there. I can't let her see me on a date with you. Why? Because, well, oh no, here she comes. Hey! There you are! I, realized if you deliver that thing, it might be a bad idea. So I'm gonna do it. Give it to me. Huh? You don't have it? Have you at least seen her? Yeah. Yes? So she's somewhere around here. Thanks, I'll keep looking. Oh my god. Well, I guess it's obvious, huh? I really like her. I mean, more than I like other people. I'm sorry. I just figured, you know, it'd be fun to go on, like, a cute kind of pretend date with you. To make you feel better. Well, it sounds even worse when I put it like that. I'm sorry, I messed up again. Undyne's the person I am. I really want to go on a date with. But I mean, she's way out of my league. Not that you aren't. Cool. But Undyne, she's so confident, strong, funny. I'm just nobody. Fraud. I'm the royal scientist, but all I've ever done is hurt people. I've told her so many lies. She thinks I'm a lot cooler than I actually am. If she gets close to me, she'll find out the truth about me. What should I do? Tell her the truth. The truth? But if I tell her that, she'll hate me. Isn't it better this way? To live a lie where both people are happy? Or a truth where neither of us are? They say be yourself, but I don't really like who myself is. I'd rather just be whatever makes people like me. No, huh? Oh, you're right. Every day I'm scared. Scared what will happen if people learn the truth on their own. They'll all get hurt because of me. How can I tell Undyne the truth? I don't have the confidence. I'm gonna mess it up. How can I practice? Obviously, let's roleplay. Roleplay? That actually sounds kind of fun. Okay, which one of us will be Undyne? I'll be Undyne, I guess. Oh, right, obviously. Ahem. Hi, Undyne. How are you doing today? Glad to hear it. So I'd like to, talk to you about something. You see, I haven't been exactly truthful with you. Oh, forget it. Undyne, I want to tell you how I feel. You're so brave and so strong, nice. You always listen to me when I talk about nerdy stuff. You always do your best to make me feel special. Like telling me that you'll beat anyone that gets in my way. Undyne, I can't take this any longer. I'm madly in love with you. Hold me, Undyne. Hold me. What did you just say? Undyne, I was just... Hey, whoa, wait a second. Your outfit's really cute. What's the occasion? Wait a second. Are you two on a date? Yes! No. I mean, no. I mean, we were. I mean, actually, we were only romantically role-playing as you. What? I mean, I mean, Undyne, I've been lying to you.
What? About what?
About, well, everything. I told you that seaweed was, like, scientifically something. Those human history books I keep reading, those are just dorky comic books. And the history movies, those are just, anime. They aren't real. The time I told you I was busy with work on the phone, I'm just eating frozen yogurt in my pajamas, Alphys. I just wanted to impress you. I just wanted you to think I was smart and cool. That I wasn't some nerdy loser. Alphys. Undyne, I really think you're neat, okay? Alphys. Shh. Alphys! I think you're neat too, I guess. But you've gotta realize, most of what you said really doesn't matter to me. I don't care if you're watching kid cartoons or reading history books. To me, all of that stuff is just nerdy crap. What I like about you is that you're passionate, you're analytical. It doesn't matter what it is. If you care about it, 100%, at maximum power. So, you don't have to lie to me. You don't want to have to lie to anyone anymore. I don't want to have to lie to anyone anymore. Alphys, I want to help you become happy with who you are. And I know just the training you need to do that. What? Me? Nah, I'm gonna get Papyrus to do it. Get those bones shaken! It's time to jog 100 laps, hooting about how great we are! Ready? I'm about to start the timer. Undyne, I'll do my best. Oh my god! She was kidding, right? Those cartoons, those comics, those are still real, right? Anime is real, right? Sorry to disappoint. No. No! You feel my heart breaking into pieces. No, I can survive this. I have to be strong for Alphys. Thank you, human, for telling me the truth. I'll try my best to live in this world. See you later. Why am I in the dump? Oh yeah, we were in the dump. We were in the dump. Okay. So, I'm hoping I don't have to go through that final battle again. If I do, I'll be very frustrated. Ring! Howdy! If it isn't my good friend who trusts me, this is Papyrus, your also mutual friend. Alphys and I finished our training early. Very early. So I sent her home. Very home. Now, I feel strongly and for no apparent reason. You should also go there. To her lab. House. I've only good feelings about this. Goodbye. Okay. Okay. This is some weird poop! Is this... Yes, there we go. Take me to the hotlands! The land of heat! The land of the hot stuff. I don't know what this is gonna achieve. I should have worn a few million more pairs of pants today. Who is this person? Okay. Yeah, travel a lot of you too. Okay, you got sent very home, and you're still filming me, and what are you doing? The space behind the wall is only a few feet wide. It's a note from Alphys. Yeah. It's hard to read because of the handwriting, but you try your best. Hey, thanks for your help back there. You guys, your support really means a lot to me, but as difficult as it is to say this, you guys alone can't magically make my own problems go away. I want to be a better person. I don't want to be afraid anymore. And for that to happen, I have to be able to face my own mistakes. I'm going to start doing that now. I want to be clear. This isn't anyone else's problem but mine. But if you don't ever hear from me again, if you want to know the truth, enter the door to the north of this note. You all at least deserve to know what I did. That's all she wrote. What did you do? Warning! Warning! Elevator losing power. New tether stability lost. Altitude dropping. Entry number one. This is it. Time to do what the king has asked me to do. I will create the power to free us all. I will unleash the power of the soul. Entry number two. The barrier is locked by soul power. Unfortunately, this power cannot be recreated artificially. Soul power can only be derived from what was once living. So to create more, we will have to use what we have now. The souls of monsters. Entry number three, but extracting a soul from a living monster would require incredible power. Besides being impractical, doing so would instantly destroy the soul's host. And unlike the persistent souls of humans, the souls of most monsters disappear immediately upon death. If only I could make a monster's soul last. I've done it. Using the blueprints, I've extracted it from the human souls. I believe this is what gives their souls the strength to persist after death. The will to keep living. The resolve to change fate. Let's call this power determination. To read the note. I can't make it all out. Elevator. Lost power. Enter the center door. That's all you can read. Now buy some chips. I can't enter the center room. Entry number six. Ask everyone outside the city for monsters that had fallen down. Their bodies came in today. They're still comatose, and soon they will all turn into dust. But what happens if I inject determination into them? If their souls persist after they perish, then freedom might be closer than we all thought. Things aren't going well. None of the bodies have turned into dust, so I can't get the souls. I told the families that I would give them the dust back for their funerals. People are starting to ask me what's happening. What do I do? Stopped. like it, because I imagine these are running on, like, residual power. How do I get the power back on? Okay, any sort of, thing hiding in the plant? Thank you for subscribing, and you guys have a great day.